Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hey friends, in the previous lecture we have talked about the molecular orbital theory, and in that case we have got to know that how the two atoms are been combining so as to form a molecular orbital. So now, similar to that, we are going to talk about the formation of the molecular orbitals but by LCO method. So what is it? Let's talk about it. So now here we are going to talk about the formation of the molecular orbitals by LCO method or by linear combination of atomic orbitals. So let me talk about this thing, that is, whenever it comes to the atomic orbital, so this atomic orbitals can be represented by the, according to wave mechanics, it can be represented by the wave functions also, and the wave function is been represented by psi. So even this can be represented in that is in the form of wave function, and for that the Schrodinger equation is been used so as to give all the details about the electron energy level and etc. It gives us more detail, but that cannot be exactly applied to this one. So that's the reason that we are applying the LCO method or linear combination of atomic orbitals method. So in this case, we have got to know that in the previous one also we have got to know that is when the atomic orbitals of the appreciable or of the comparable energy, when they are combining with each other, and then only the number of the molecular orbitals are being formed. So now, this kind of the molecular orbitals are also been distributed into different energy levels, and this energy level can be represented with this wave function, and that wave function can be written as in this way, as I'm going to mention. So those wave functions are being represented in this way, that is, I'm going to represent. That is psi b and psi a. So what does this mean? Psi b actually it represents the wave function for the molecular orbitals when they are forming a bonding molecular orbital. While talking about psi a, it represents the wave function of anti-bonding orbitals and how they are been formed. Suppose if I'm talking about the two atoms like that of A and B, like this one, if I would represent it in this way. So suppose if this are the two atoms, if they are combining with each other, so therefore this is the atom A and this is the atom B. So if they are combining with each other, obviously they will be combining with each other according to the atomic orbitals energy. So what happens is whenever they will have the same kind of energy, and then only they will they will combine with each other so as to form a molecule. And not only they should have the same energy, but they should have also the symmetry also as well as the stability also. So that is what it plays a very vital role in understanding that according to the LCO method, that how the two atoms are being combined so as to form a molecule. So let us come back to this again. So this is what I have represented over here, that is psi b and psi a. This represents the bonding wave function of the bonding or atomic molecular orbital, while this one is the wave function of antibonding molecular orbitals. So now this is because of the algebraic combination of that is psi a and psi b, while this it represents the atomic orbital or the wave function of the atomic orbital of the atom A, and this represents the wave function of the atomic orbital that is B. So if they are combining with each other in such a way, then we could say that the bonding will happen, and that is what the bonding molecular orbital will create. And this is how when when two atoms, when they are combining, and even though the nucleus are being influenced to each other, and that's the reason that suppose if the nucleus forms in such a combination, suppose if the nucleus forms in such a way where the symmetry has been more obtained as well as the stability has been obtained, then we could say that the bonding can be observed. While suppose if kind of repulsion, if it creates, if the two nucleus, if they create repulsion, then we could say that the antibonding would happen, and that is what the antibonding, the wave function of the antibonding can be represented by this way. So it is not necessary that we should always represent A first. We can also write it as that is psi of B minus psi of A. So there is no change in that meaning, because it gives an idea that the two atoms, that is A plus B, if they combine, then the bonding will happen, and if they repel or if they won't combine, then the antibonding orbital, molecular orbital will create, and this is what the detail is. So let me talk about a few more detail about this thing. So this is what it is related to energy also, as well as it is related to combination also. So So in the future lecture also, we are going to see in this way, where this is what I have represented about the energy level. And suppose if I am combining two atoms, and those atoms has an atomic orbital that could be represented as that is psi A and psi B, like this way. Suppose this is the atomic orbital for psi A, suppose. And but we have also got to know that they will form the molecular orbital while combining, if they will have same kind of energy, if the other atom also have same kind of energy. So that is what, suppose if the other atom, like the other atom's atomic orbital, like this one, that is psi B. Now they will have almost same energy, and now we could say that they can have, they have the possibility so as to combine with each other. And that is what we have got to know, that whenever that is the two atoms or atomic orbital, whenever they are combining, so obviously the same number of molecular orbital will be created. So here basically one orbital of psi A and one orbital of psi B, if they are combining, then two molecular orbitals will be created, and the one will have a lower energy and the one of the molecular orbital will have higher energy. So this is what I am representing over here. That is, one of the atomic orbital, one of the molecular orbital will have lower energy, and one of the molecular orbital will have same amount of, is the difference will be the same, and it will have, that is, higher energy. So this is what I have represented over here, and here I have not represented any kind of electrons or something, but it represents the molecular orbitals. So if I compare it with the energy, then this is the energy difference from the original one, or from the parent atom, if I would say. So this is the energy difference that I have got over here. So this, since it is present in the lower one, so obviously the lower energy is more stable, and that is what we have discussed in our previous lecture also. Suppose if the nucleus, if or the two of the nucleus or the electrons, if they have attraction towards each other, and if they are more symmetrical, then only they will combine, and if they don't have, they will basically, they will repel each other. So in this case, basically, since this one or this molecular orbital have less energy, means it is more stable, and that is what we could represent, that this atomic or this molecular orbital is basically bonding molecular orbital, or this is the wave function of the bonding molecular orbital. But talking about the above one, actually it has higher energy compared to that of the original one, and that is the reason that it is called to be wave function of anti-bonding molecular orbital. So this were the two things that I was talking about in terms of the LCO method. So LCO method, it, as the name is, it's as such, as you have got to know, that is, it is linear combination of the atomic orbitals. So obviously they will combine with each other in such a way that the two molecular orbitals will be formed, and moreover we could say that the molecules would be more stable, not only if they will have lesser energy, but it will also depends on how much they are overlapping on each other. So the extent of overlapping, that is what I was talking about. So these are the few details that I was talking about, that is the formation of a molecular orbital. That is, this is the formation of a molecular orbital during the combination of the atomic orbitals. So that's it. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have got to know various concepts behind this one. So I hope you will share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to the EKIDA channel. Thank you so much.